In this video, we are going to talk about the importance of Docker and Kubernetes in a data science workflow and why organization embracing AI should use it. Now, Docker is a popular container environment and Kubernetes is a platform for orchestrating Docker or other containers. Docker allows application to be packaged in a self-contained environment, which makes it easy to deploy, as well as it brings parity between your development environment and deployment environment. Kubernetes, on the other hand, automates all your networking, security, and other aspect of container management, and more importantly, provides a mechanism to scale your container rapidly. Kubernetes and Docker are pretty important in your machine learning lifecycle, both from development and deployment aspect, as it makes your entire workflow simple, consistent, and scalable. We will now discuss the three major areas where Kubernetes can be beneficial in the data science workflow. The first one is infrastructure. Now, infrastructure is a key investment in any data science initiative. Enterprises typically invest in high-performance system or GPUs to accelerate data science initiative. If you really see the usage pattern of this infrastructure, typically when the model training or the model hypothesis phase is going on, the usage is pretty high. But once the model development is completed, the infrastructure is pretty much idle. What Kubernetes allows us, it brings in a mechanism to efficiently share resources and enable multi-tenancy. So what this means is there can be multiple AI projects within infrastructure, within the organization, that can use the same infrastructure at the same time have that bare minimum required quota that is required to run their model. So basically you are utilizing your infrastructure in a better and efficient way, and at the same time you get better ROI on your infrastructure investment. The second benefit is tooling and reproducibility. If you see today data science workflow, we use numerous tools. It can be TensorFlow, it can be PyTorch, it can be scikit-learn, it can be R. And each of this specific version of the tool, like TensorFlow 2.0 or TensorFlow 1.6, has its own set of dependencies with NumPy, Pandas, and other ecosystem component. It becomes very difficult to manage in an hardwired infrastructure to have this multiple version deployed together and maintain multiple Conda environment. So with multi-tenancy, one more benefit that containers bring in is basically you can package all the dependency per project in your own container environment. Basically, you're creating a virtualized environment with all dependencies packaged in that your specific use case can use. And similarly, other use case can have their own dependency bundled together. Now, what this also brings in is reproducibility. So basically, once your model is developed, you just pass on the container to the software engineer to deploy it with all dependency in it, rather than sending a big instruction manual on what to install and how to deploy. This makes your production and your development environment highly reproducible and consistent. The final benefit is deployment and scaling. If you see an end-to-end pipeline, basically, the training pipeline is nothing but a mechanism to collect data, pre-process data, future engineer, and then train the model. And once the model is trained, basically you save the model, and then in your deployment pipeline, you need to kind of replicate the entire workflow of data collection, data pre-processing, future engineering, and you kind of load the saved model in a serving function, and then you kind of inference on it. Now, what you can do is this serving function can be a regular Flask app that kind of calls all the pre-processing pipeline and loads the model, right? And what you can do is this Flask app, you can basically instruct in a Docker file while deployment to start the Flask app and keep it up and running for serving incoming request. One of the key benefit of Kubernetes over here is the scaling. Right now, your application might have peak volume during the weekend or during the day hours and pretty less volume during the night time. So what you can do is basically you can instruct your Kubernetes to auto scale your model container during the peak hours and weekend, and then run on minimum capacity during the night hours. This way you're bringing efficiency in your infrastructure utilization. You can also build deployment strategies like blue-green deployment, canary deployment, or A-B deployment, right? Like you may have a champion model and a challenger model, and you want to instruct like, okay, 50% of the volume goes to my champion model and 50% of my volume goes to my challenger model. All this is seamlessly possible with Kubernetes in place.